Hello students, welcome to the session. Today's topic is DC and AC equivalent circuits. From the paper 6, physics paper 6, unit 3 of analog electronics. So DC and AC equivalent circuits. In the last class we studied something about amplifiers. And this is the extended part of the same topic, amplifiers and their components and all. So in this class, let us see what is a DC and AC equivalent circuit. In a transistor amplifier, both AC and DC condition prevail. In this circuit diagram, we can see that this contains both DC source as well as AC. So function generator will be here in the first part, and here the entire circuit is connected with a power supply plus VCC. So plus VCC is a DC source and this function generator is an AC source. So in this CE amplifier, both DC as well as AC condition prevail. The DC source provides the appropriate bias and the energy needed for the amplification. So why the DC supply is required here? Because that provides bias of the transistor and energy needed for the amplification. So in this CE amplifier circuit, the DC supply provides bias voltage for the transistor and energy needed for the amplification. So any small signal which is applied in the base will be amplified at the collector. So consequently, DC voltages and currents are set up in the circuit. An AC signal when fed to the amplifier causes fluctuations in these currents and voltages. So when the circuit is switched on, already there will be DC supply that in order to run the transistor, in order to function, it requires DC supply. So already DC will be there. When AC signal is fed to the amplifier, so that signal causes fluctuations in the currents and voltages. It is easier to understand the working of the circuit if DC and AC analysis are considered separately. So in this circuit, both DC and AC conditions prevail. So in order to understand the working of the CE amplifier, this circuit, if DC and AC components are analyzed separately, that will be easy to understand. So to get the total currents and voltages, the DC and AC values are finally added. So now let us separate AC and DC and then let us combine. In DC equivalent circuit, so first let us consider only DC condition and no AC is present now. So that circuit is called as AC DC equivalent circuit. In this DC equivalent circuit, we can see this part is same as this. So this original circuit is made like this in DC equivalent. So DC equivalent is nothing but AC components are not considered here. So there are mainly two conditions in order to obtain DC equivalent circuit from the original circuit. So let us see what are the conditions. Only DC values are considered here, that is, it is pre-assumed that no AC signal is present. So to get a DC equivalent circuit, we have to consider that, we have to assume that all capacitors are treated as open and all AC sources are treated as shorts. So in this original circuit, to get DC equivalent circuit, treat all capacitors as open and all AC sources as shorts. So in the original circuit, AC source which is presented here is treated as short. That means it is not there. Imagine that the AC source is absent. So in order to treat it as zero or absent, short the AC source. And the capacitor CS is considered as open. So when the capacitor is opened here and here and here, all the three capacitors are opened. So what we left with is only R1, R2, RC and RE. So capacitor which is present here parallel to RE is open, so no component is there. And CS capacitor which comes to the base is treated as open, so it is absent now. And this AC is considered as short, so one end of the end of the base is connected to the junction itself. So this part will not be there because this is shorted and this is treated as open. RS will be there inside VIN itself, so that is shorted. So we left with only this much, and this capacitor is open, this capacitor is open. So when both are open, this RL has no meaning, and only this much portion of the circuit represents DC equivalent circuit. So in order to obtain a DC equivalent circuit from the original CE amplifier circuit, two conditions are essential. They are, all the capacitors must be treated as open and all AC sources are treated as shorts. That means they are zero. So with this circuit, the voltages and currents can be calculated. So voltages and currents due to only DC source are calculated here, and then in the later section we will calculate the current and voltages due to AC source, and finally they are combined to obtain the total voltages and currents from both the section, from both AC as well as DC. So that will give the total current and voltage from this CE amplifier circuit. In the next class, we shall see what is AC equivalent circuit.